because of their wages for board and lodging. Please turn them longer among you.
Here's your new desk, kid. You're on traffic. The hot sheet is posted here, next to the map.
What's his problem?
That's Biggs. He's an institution.
So this is what all the fuss is about. Why couldn't they build a freeway that goes past my place?
They haven't even approved the money yet, kid. The bond issue won't be till December. It'll be years before any of this will happen. Here's your new partner, Stefan Berkowski.
I've heard all about you, Phelps. You go easy on me and let me earn the odd citation, and maybe we'll get along fine.
I'm here to learn, Detective.
Oh, he's an intense one, isn't he, Mel?
Who's intense?
The newly minted detective here, Cole Phelps.
Hi, Phelps. I'll be keeping an eye on you. I could spend a little time basking in reflected glory, make a change from busting hookers and dope fiends.
Who was that, Commander?
Roy Earle, chief detective and advice.
Do they all dress like movie stars?
Well, Roy is a movie star. And the whole of the seedy side of L.A. is his audience.
What is that supposed to mean?
Stick with me, kid. You'll find out.
And now some housekeeping. Warm Central Division welcome for Detective Cole Phelps. Some of you guys may know Phelps. He's the cop who broke the jewelry store murder. Stand up and take a bow, Phelps.
If it's all right with
That's
you, sir.
Order, Phelps.
Ooh.
Shh, quiet, everybody.
Phelps is one of only two serving LAPD officers who received the Silver Star during the war. You really gave it those lousy Japanese, eh, Phelps?
I did my best, Captain.
Why are you war heroes always so modest? I've partnered Phelps with everybody's favorite Pole, Stefan Bukowski.
Hope you like work, kid. Bukowski sure as hell doesn't.
Well, that's why we have partners, right?
Okay, can it, guys. Stick with Bukowski. He's a good cop. He knows traffic inside now. I'm going to start you out with one case. You do okay, I'll give you a couple more. You screw up, you'll be rousting vagrants and running license plates. Now get down to the P.E. Freight Depot, 6th and Alameda. A patrolman called in a suspicious vehicle. Signs of foul play. See what you can find out.
Come on, Phelps.
Goddamn captain's making me resubmit the paperwork.
They really pushed you quick, didn't they? 6 years on patrol before I got this desk. You were here in 5 minutes.
What do you want me to say? I didn't ask for any favors.
Mary says he'll sing, but only if I guarantee he walks.
Isn't that the cop? Big case.
You know this place?
Sure. Near the old gasworks and signal depot in the warehouse district.
I'll direct.
All units, a 459 just occurred at 6th and Sarah.
So, tell me a little about yourself, Phelps.
Are we friends now, Bukowski?
We have to work together. Don't be so touchy.
Grew up in San Francisco. My father was in shipping. Went to college at Stanford. Did 2 years ROTC before Marine OCS at Camp Elliott. Shipped out in early 45 as a first lieutenant, fought in the Okinawa campaign. I was wounded, shipped back home. Had a year on the beat, now I'm here.
So you won the Silver Star.
I don't want to talk about it.
Now let me get this straight. You single-handedly killed 40 Japs on this hill in Okinawa.
No. You were up there all night,
draped in a flag, knife between your teeth, gun at the ready.
You finished?
The Emperor Hirohito himself leading the charge against you.
I did my part, Bukowski. What did you do?
I kept the streets of L.A. safe for the people.
Yeah. Now I get it. Unfit for service.
Oh, fuck you, Phelps. I earned a bravery citation during the Zooter riots.
Sounds like you had it rough.
I did my job.
No one is saying you didn't.
I did 6 years as a patrolman.
That's the third time you've told me.
Oh, I'm afraid someday you leave
459 just occurred at 6th and Saris. Any unit to handle, code 2, identify.
11 King, go ahead, KGPO.
Up on the roof, officer. He has a mask on his face. I caught sight when he shoved past me, but be careful. I saw him waving a gun.
Give it up now. Make it easy on yourself.
Get the hell away from me.
Let's negotiate.
Put the weapon down now. You want to back off right now.
The swoosh of the dish rag gets them sparkling clean. Try it.
Wow, these pots sure are clean.
See? You'll be whistling too with how easy it is to clean up after dinner with Leather Wash. Lazy old...
We've got a siren for a reason.
...scrubbing and elbow grease. Leather Wash gets grease and takes it right down the drain. And since Leather Wash removes spots for the pots and pans, use it to remove the grease spots that occasionally get on clothes and that moths love to feed upon. Just listen to the whistle. The Lemon Wash whistle means it's gotta be clean. Lemon Wash, all-purpose cleaner.
That you, Bukowski? Go on through. Parking lot straight ahead.
I need to get back to work, officer.
The detectives are here now. You repeat to them what you told me.
I did the right thing by calling this in. I'm just a working stiff.
Just give them your story and you'll be all right.
This is your first case, Phelps. It's okay to admit it if you're stumped. If you don't know what to do next, just come talk to me and... we'll see what we can figure out.
Thanks, Stefan. You're okay.
I'm Officer Hart.
Phelps, traffic. What have you got?
Abandoned car, probably stolen. The solid citizen is Nate Wilkie. He called it in.
What gives with the coroner?
There's blood all over the interior. Someone's copped the full Broderick, but no stiff as yet.
We have an owner for the car?
The car is registered to an Adrian Black, just north of Bunker Hill.
All right, we'll take a look around.
I'll keep Mr. Wilkie talking, but don't make him wait too long. He's the restless type.
Nice day for it.
How long are you gonna keep me here, sir?
I better get back to work, sir.
How's the world looking?
Always the same to us.
Doc, Detective Phelps, what have we got?
A lot of blood for a blunt force injury. Victim must be in a very bad way.
Any sign of the guy?
Not unless he's in the trunk of the car.
Circumstantial. Mr. F. Morgan picked up a live pig yesterday? This isn't what we're looking for. Old, married, sounds like an average guy. What was he doing out here? Happier times, I guess. Stenzel glasses. Home repaired by the look of it.
Searching.
Victim looks to have lost a lot of blood.
Thank you.
What's going on, detective? Something bad happened here?
How about 50 bucks?
Something to go on.
Let me through. I just want a quick look, you know.
Sir, I'm Detective Phelps.
Name's Nate Wilkie.
You found the vehicle?
Sure. Saw it just sitting there. Strange place to be parking your car. Figured I'd better take a look. And then I saw all the blood. So I called the police.
Mind if I ask what you were doing out here?
Well, I work for the railway. I was on my way out to the switch and reckon I'd take a shortcut.
Did you see anybody else in the yard? Maybe somebody hanging around the car?
Nope. I hadn't seen a soul all day till you boys turned up.
Do you know Adrian Black, Mr. Wilkie?
No, sir. That ain't a name I'm familiar with.
You ever seen the car before?
Funny enough, I did. A couple of nights ago, it was over there in the parking lot. I know most of the cars that park here regular, so it kind of stood out.
The wallet by the car. Was there anything in it when you arrived?
You accusing me of something, mister?
Do you want the patrolman to hold you down while we turn out your pockets, Mr. Wilkie?
Maybe I checked inside that wallet. Not that I was gonna steal anything. Maybe I took a look. But there weren't no money in there. Not even change.
We found a steel pipe with blood on it near the car. Do you know anything about it, Mr. Wilkie?
No, sir. I went straight for the law when I saw the car was full of blood.
When you saw the blood, was it wet, bright red, or darker like it is now?
Darker, I'd say. Looked dry already.
Thank you for your help, Mr. Wilkie. We'll contact your employer if we need anything more from you.
If you have to, I guess. I can't really spend no more time over this.
Somebody's got to inform the wife, Phelps. You're done here. We'll head over there now. You can drive.
All right.
Where to?